Hi, my name is Johannes and I'm a product owner at Tesla. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you create and set up the OPC UA Server Status sensor so you can monitor a bunch of devices like SCADA systems, MES systems, PLCs and many more. Have fun! Okay, let's start right away monitoring an OPC UA server using PRTG. At first, we have to add a device as usual. In our case, we already have it here. It's a backup IPC. To add the sensor, you need to check the credential sections as you're used to. So go to settings and there you find all the credentials for the device. And there's also one now for OPC UA. You need to specify a port. Usually it's 4840. In our case, we have it already adapted to 4852 for our backup IPC device. You need to also specify the server path, which is the path to your OPC UA server, like the application URI. As security mode, currently we support none, sign, sign and encrypt. And if you select sign and encrypt or sign, you have the chance to add a client certificate, the client key and the proper password for it. As security policy, we support right now basic 256 and SHA 256 and basic 256. But in our case, it's not needed, so we just start right away with none. And as the authentication method, we support anonymous and username password. So if you have a system which requires username password authentication, just select it, enter your proper credentials, and that's it. As I said, not needed in our case, so we start with anonymous and security mode none. Now we add the sensor and go to the Add Sensor dialog and search for OPC UA. And there you already see a bunch of sensors, but in this video we just focus on the OPC UA Server Status 1. Quite easy to add, no settings required. And here we go. Wait until all the data is received from the server. And so here we go, all channels are loaded. The first one is the server status channel, which shows us, as its name, the server status. In our case, it's up and running, so everything is fine. But of course, if there's an issue, communication fault or failed, or the system shutting down, you get a proper alert. That's pretty nice. Further, we support the rejected request count and the rejected sessions count. If the number increases here, something is probably wrongly configured or someone is trying to access the system which has not the proper privileges. In more detail, you're going to see that in the security rejected request count and security rejected session count, which means if you see an increasing number here, somebody is trying to access your system without the proper authentication or tries to read notes from the server which he is not privileged to. So setting a proper threshold here can be very interesting. Next, we have the session abort count, so how many sessions were just dropped, and the session timeout count. Session timeout count could be very interesting if you have, for example, networking issues. So sessions just timeout because the network is down. Also here we have the subscription count, which just shows how many active subscriptions are currently ongoing on the server, and the session count. So in our case, 12 sessions are currently ongoing on the server. And as the last channel, we have the uptime, which is quite interesting. So our system runs since 234 days without a reboot. So if you set a proper threshold there, you can be sure you get notified if the system reboots without notice. So as a last thing, we can set a proper threshold as usual for the session count. So if we can, or if we want to protect our system for overloading, we could say we want to get a warning if we have more than 15 sessions ongoing. And after 20 sessions, we want to get a proper alert because it might overload our system. And as you can see, we already have it here. So still we are in the green part, but as soon as we go above 15 concurrent sessions, we get a proper notification. And that's basically everything you need to know to monitor your OPC UA servers using PRTG. I hope you really found this tutorial helpful. And if so, please give us a like or consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. Also, leave us a comment for feedback or any other topics. And if there are any questions, always ask us at support@pesla.com. Thanks for watching.